Hello, viewers, friends, subscribers. It is AG, and today we are playing Mega Man 5 for the PS Quadruple. Initially, I didn't really like Mega Man 5. Actually, I thought it was okay. Back in the day, I rented that Blockbuster Video, you know, back in those days. I remember seeing it, and I was like, I didn't even know there was a Mega Man 5. Whoa! I actually didn't even know there was Mega Man 6 until way later. I didn't play Mega Man 6 until the GameCube collection. Hope the sound is okay. It took me a while to set this up again. I did have a video playing Drawn to Death last time, and the sound was poop, so I just deleted it. So here we go, Mega Man 5, Mega Man 5, Mega Man 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've already played through 1 through 4, so if you want to watch those streams, you can. You're more than welcome to. I can't really lower the in-game sound on this, so hopefully you guys can hear me okay. And I can't really hear on my TV, but I don't want it to be too loud. So, destruction's going on. You know, Proto Man's being a jerk, I guess. What are you doing, Proto Man? I thought you were my brother. I thought you were my brother, Proto Man. How can you just kidnap Dr. Light like this? Here we go, Mega Man 5. 1992. It's a long time ago. In a galaxy not that far away. It's actually the Milky Way galaxy on planet Earth. So, here we are. Who do I pick first? I'm not as familiar with these guys as I am with Mega Man 1, 2, 3, and 4. Even then, I wasn't really too familiar, but, you know what? We're gonna go, like, Starman. He looks easy. You know? Because stars and, like, Mario are helpful, so maybe Starman won't be as bad to fight. I don't remember the order on this game. I forgot to turn off my phone. I don't like when you go on your phone and then you, I don't want notifications, and then, these apps still send you notifications. Like, what the hell? Yeah, I really can't hear my TV, so. Oh, this is like anti-gravity, in this. So, in this Mega Man, I remember there's like a power-up that gives you this suit. I think it's this one, or is it 6? No, that's 6, huh? So in this one, you have to spell out Mega Man 5, and I believe you get this bird that hangs out with you, and it can kill enemies from far away. Don't remember the bird's name. Super Mario Poke Nerd in the house. What's up, man? Playing some Mega Man 5. Yeah, I don't even know what I'm doing. This level, I was going into this thinking it's going to be easy, but we'll see. We'll see. I don't remember it. I'm almost done with all the trophies in this game. I still have to beat this game, Mega Man 6, and then I have to complete the challenges. So I think I have 4 trophies left in this game to get 100%. Strange, it doesn't have a platinum, but you know. You know, Capcom, just holding back for the fans. Hold it back on those fans that treated them so well. Should I risk my life for that M? Got it. And, so yeah, we're gonna continue on. Oh, see, I remember this part. Do I have rush coil or rush something? I don't know, guys. This is gonna be embarrassing if I can't get past this. Oh my god. Yeah, I might be one of those kind of knights. I think I can jump over that without, like, a rush. You know, a rush dog to help me. I forgot which rush it was. The one that flies over, Rush Jet. Hopefully I don't need a Rush Jet to fly over this, but I think I can do it. I think I gotta trust my instincts. Trust your instincts, Fox! Okay, good. Oh god, I thought I almost hit that top one. Alright, I'm gonna do a slide there, there we go. This is your first Mega Man game? Mine was 4, believe it or not. So yeah, it sounds like we started late in the Mega Man series, huh? I rented this one, like I said in the beginning of the stream here. I rented this one not knowing it existed until I think I saw it in a magazine. There was a Mega Man 5. Like, I think Nintendo Power or something had it. I was like, Mega Man 5? No way. So, and I thought Gravity Man looked so cool. Like, I like the design of Gravity Man. So, he was my favorite out of this game. But this game itself wasn't ever a favorite of mine. It just, it didn't appeal to me like the others did. When I say others, I mean like Mega Man 2 and 3. I didn't play 1 until the GameCube collection. I didn't play Mega Man 6 until the GameCube collection. I never found Mega Man 1. I never remember seeing Mega Man 1 in stores, so that was a weird thing. I know everyone likes to talk about the box art and how bad it was, but I never remember seeing Mega Man 1 in the stores. So, that was kind of weird. You always saw Mega Man 2 and 3, but... And then when 4 came out, but I don't ever remember seeing 1 or 6. I never remember seeing 6. This game on NES is, I believe it's expensive to get. Alright, hopefully this guy is easy, because I don't remember... I don't remember the pattern and all that. Oh, okay, it's gonna be like that, huh? So he's like slow moving. Oh my gosh, my aim is off. So this guy has the Skull Man weapon, the Wood Man weapon. You know, this weapon has been used in most of the Mega Man games, where you have like this shield around you. Okay, what is he doing? Can you just not do that? Oh man. I'm not used to the anti-gravity jumps. So yeah, this, who else had this weapon? Plant Man, right? He's in Mega Man 6. So, yeah, you know, Capcom, they're just reusing ideas and, you know, they gotta do what they gotta do. So, I can't blame them for that. Here we go, my phone with more notifications, and I placed no notifications and it still says, oh, notifications for you. So, what did Mega Man get? You got Star Crash and Super Arrow! I wonder if there were voice acting in Mega Man. If that would... Nah, it wouldn't be that. It would be like, you got Super Arrow! You know how Mega Man voices are always so, like, cartoony? I don't know. I don't know if you guys ever seen the anime or cartoon or stuff. Stage left. Continue. What would continue go to? Like, back to the same stage? I think Starman kills Gravity Man, because, Gravity Man does this thing where he goes on the ceiling, and then he falls, and then you have to throw the stars at him. I think I remember that. The music in this game is not as memorable as the other Mega Mans. Mega Man 2 and 3, I've voiced my praise for them plenty of times. Plenty. Oh, this is a cool level, though. I like this little, dynamic gimmick, whatever you want to call it, where you flip upside down. Other games have used this before. I'm pretty sure Mario Galaxy did this. That's the first thing that came to mind, but I know other games have used that mechanic of, being able to climb, like, walk on the ceilings like this and stuff. Pretty neat. Pretty fun thing to do. Kind of throws you off a little bit if you're not used to it. Is there something here? No. Again, since my sound on my TV is so low, I can barely hear it. So, I don't really have any sound cues to help me out. Barely hear it, but it's fine. I can survive. I'm talking about this, about notifications. I was talking about, I downloaded this app that shows your PlayStation trophies. I don't know which one it is. There's a couple out there, but I recently put no notifications and then still saying, oh, this friend is online, that friend is online. I don't need to know when everybody's online, you know. Oh, there's one of those M's again. Let's see. I think I've only collected that Mega Man 5, like this whole thing. You know, where it spells out Mega Man 5? I think I've only collected that once in all the years this game has been out. Because I do remember having a bird at one time. But after that, I would always miss it. Never played this level? What do you mean by Pokemon? Pokemon. Get it! Okay. So, there's this Disney collection that came out, and I'm interested in getting. I'm surprised that it's not coming to the Switch. That would be a fun game to have on the Switch, because, you know, I'm still playing Zelda. I'm taking my time with Zelda, you know, I'm still avoiding spoilers and everything, and... You know, I'm taking my time with it, that's all I have to say. But, what was I talking about? Yeah, this Disney collection that just came out for PS4. It has DuckTales, DuckTales 2, and all that. Chippendales, Rescue Rangers, all these NES games. And there's no Switch release, Capcom. What are you doing? Doesn't make any sense to me. It doesn't make sense to my brain. I just died. The enemy looks like a Pokeball. Oh yeah, he did, huh? I know what you're talking about. So the Disney collection's not coming out for the Switch. I was like, come on, Capcom, throw us a bone. But I don't want to be like that, because that was the Wii U. It's like Wii U in a way. I think all these companies are very hesitant with Nintendo, because like, I don't know. I don't know if it's gonna actually be... You know. They wouldn't want to take the risk. At the very least, Capcom, you could put it as a digital download. Well, I think it already is a digital download. I guess I didn't need the star power. I wasn't even paying attention. But you're supposed to use a Starman weapon on this guy. Just FYI, people. I was just talking and totally forgot to use it. So I'm gonna get that Disney collection. I'll probably play it for you guys here. I love Chippendales Rescue Rangers on NES. And DuckTales. I never played DuckTales 2, so that'd be cool to play. I think I rented Chippendale 2, and I rented Tailspin. I was never a fan of the Tailspin cartoon. I thought it had the worst, like, the theme song was so annoying to me when I was little. I always changed the channel every time Tailspin would come on, because I hated that theme song. It's just so annoying to me. Belmont, what's up, man? Simon Belmont from Castlevania in the house. In the house. You can tell I'm from the 90s. Stuck in the 90s. AG, definitely. We're just talking about recent games not coming for Nintendo again, you know. Not coming from the... Oh, do you want games for your Nintendo Switch? Oh, get a PlayStation, I guess. I mean, come on, guys. I don't understand it, you know. Maybe it'll take a couple years. Nintendo has to sell like 20 million units. And then maybe companies will be like, okay, you know what? Let's start making games for the Switch. So maybe if Nintendo actually sells 20 million by 2019, you know, maybe third party will get on board. Maybe. I don't know. I think companies really don't have a good relationship with Nintendo because of the past. So we'll see. We'll see. I don't know. I've just been playing Zelda on the Switch. I'm loving it. I just haven't been playing as much. I'm playing Final Fantasy 15 at the same time. I started Horizon Zero Dawn. And, yeah. So I went back to Final Fantasy 15, which I stopped playing in January. So I want to beat it. So, you know. Boards and doors. I know exactly what you're talking about. The Grimling is here at the Game Capsule. Grimling, welcome. Playing Mega Man Cinco on the PS Quadruple. talking about Nintendo Switch. See, we're all over the place, people. All over the place. On PlayStation, talk about Nintendo. What kind of loyalty is that to Sony? I love how back in the day when I did YouTube videos, like, hey, gee, you're such a Nintendo fanboy. You know, and I probably was. But I never considered myself a fanboy because I wasn't, like, those people that were, like, they blindly always supported Nintendo no matter what happened. Like, oh, the Wii U doesn't have games. I love the Wii U still. Like, you know, and if you criticize the Wii U, people get angry. Listen, I love the Wii U. I haven't played it in a year, though. I mean, I need to, like I said, I think in my previous videos, I had moved and then I never hooked it back up, you know. So, that's on me. And now that I got a Switch, will I hook up my Wii U again? Eventually, down the road. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe came out today, folks. So if you never played Mario Kart 8 and you have a Nintendo Switch, that's a game to pick up. Especially if you haven't played the Wii U version. The Wii U version is pretty damn good, people. I must say, it's pretty damn good. Oh man. Oh my gosh. This is stupid. Oh, that's stupid. I don't even know if that counted. The Wii U is okay. It is just needs more games. Yeah, Belmont, I'm saying. Stupid bonus. Screw Attack was interesting. That's a long time ago. Grimling. It's a long time ago. I don't remember the last time Screw Attack was interesting. It's been a while. Screw Attack, I guess I was watching them when ABGN was new, so that was a long time ago. Yeah, Belmont. Seriously, I'm guessing the Switch has to sell much more right now. It's selling very well. It's already at close to 3 million units sold. Oh god, I don't remember how to do this. 3 million units sold. I think it's 2.5 exactly, but I really want, I mean, it's kind of, I kind of get worried because if the new Call of Duty is not going to be on the Switch, and I'm like, uh-oh. I mean, I know not everybody's fans of Call of Duty, but, you know, these AAA guys have to support the Switch, or, you know, it's going to make people think, oh, Nintendo is going to be like the Wii U again, and now, what's the point of getting it? So, hopefully we see Activision change their mind and Sledgehammer bring World War II, Call of Duty to the Switch. No, I hope we see Battlefront on the Switch. Again, it's kind of scary, because I always see on Facebook, because I follow a whole bunch of Nintendo pages, and there's one page I follow, is every day it's like, this game not coming to the Switch. This game not coming to the Switch. And then people in the comments are saying, oh, that's okay. We don't need that game. We don't need to play that. And it's funny because the past 4 years on Nintendo Wii U, it was the same exact thing. Like, okay, send, we don't want games on our console. It never made sense to me. What am I supposed to use here? Gravity hold, right? This boss is stupid with this weapon. I can, like, I'm hitting him without even hitting him. That's dumb. The Switch is the Nvidia Shield. No! Yeah, but at the same time, I don't even know if the Switch could even run. Yeah, but do you remember that Call of Duty was on the Wii? Black Ops was on the Wii? If they have to downgrade, they can. They can do it. And if they downgrade for the Switch, it's still gonna look good. It's just not gonna look as good as the other versions. As I drink out of my baby bottle. That's what these Arrowhead waters look like. They look like baby bottles. Mmm. Kakagookoo. Because they do that on purpose. Because they know we're all just babies. Grown babies. Yeah, Black Ops 1 was on Wii. World of War was on Wii. What else was on Wii? I think Black Ops was the last one, right? I'm trying to remember. Modern Warfare 3 was on the Wii. Well, I hope they do it, because I bought Black Ops 2 on Wii U, and I put it like 100 hours into it. I put like 100 hours into the Wii U version of Black Ops 2. It was a fun game. I had a Wii U, I was like, what the hell, why not? Then I bought Ghosts, and then I was like, that was a mistake. I bought that on launch day, and that was a big mistake. I never beat it. I barely played the multiplayer. Yeah, it wasn't a good game. So that turned me off of Call of Duty for a while until I just bought Black Ops 3. Actually, I didn't buy it. I got it as a gift, because I was actually looking forward to it. I really like Black Ops 2. So a friend of mine at my last job had bought me it for Christmas, so that was kind of cool to do, that he did that. And all the DLC, which I haven't really played. I didn't really get into the zombies. I did. I beat all the main zombie stuff. Like, I'm almost about to get the platinum on Black Ops 3. But there's like, you have to beat the professional mode, and that's like if you get shot once, you die. So it's hard as hell. And then the other trophy that I have to get in that game is you have to collect all these secret, hidden items, and I don't know, it's just like tedious grinding, and so I kind of put it off. I was like, okay, I'll get that trophy another time. Back to what we're talking about, the Switch, man. It needs those third-party games to survive. I know Zelda, as wonderful as it is, it can't sustain the console in the long run. Mario will help. Mario Kart will definitely help. I expect to see more Wii U ports, FYI. I expect to see most of Wii U's library ported to the Switch. So, you know, you might see a Bayonetta 3, and then they'll probably port 1 and 2 over to the Switch. You know, things like that. That's just me speculating, so don't think that's actual news. You know, stuff like, what else? Or like I'm trying to remember all the big Wii U. Smash Brothers. Smash Brothers will probably get a port, because I doubt Sakurai is going to make a new one so soon. But, you know, who knows? Maybe they're already starting on it. The last Call of Duty was Modern Warfare 2, which was, that was one of the best ones. Heck, I don't even think some were on like the DS. You're talking about Call of Duty? Yeah, there was Call of Duty on the DS and stuff like that, so. You can port it! I mean, there's no excuse. They're just afraid to lose money, that's the thing. And they need Contra, Castlevania. Yeah. I agree with that. I don't think we'll see a Castlevania, though, because Konami is, they don't like making money on video games anymore. I don't know. I'm getting killed by these penises flying at me. Metal penises. Yeah. Castlevania. I wish there was a 2D Castlevania again. I know there was plenty of them on the DS and things like that, but it would be nice to see a console version. What was that 3D one that came out on the PS3? What was that called? I played it a long time ago. I didn't play through it, but I went to E3 one of those years, and it was a 3D Castlevania, but it didn't even feel like Castlevania. Lord of Shadows, yeah. You know, it doesn't feel like 3D Castlevania never felt like Castlevania. Even the Nintendo 64 versions, they didn't feel like Castlevania. I mean, it was cool at the time that there was a 3D Castlevania on N64, but that game was hard, for one thing, like, way hard, because the game was broken. Controls were really stiff and everything. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna die again at this place. Alright, get that life, at the very least. Oh god, don't die, please. God damn it. The Super NES Classic. Oh, Super NES Classic, yeah, I heard about that. Now, is that confirmed? Or is that just a rumor right now? I wouldn't doubt that there would be a Super NES Classic, but I don't think it really makes sense this time, because I thought the NES Classic was because Nintendo wanted to make some money last Christmas, because the Wii U wasn't going to sell. So they're like, we need something to sell over Christmas. What could we do, guys? And then someone at Nintendo was like, why don't we just, like, package, like, some of our old games that people forgot about? And then, like, you know, I don't know, like, give it to them again, but then sell it for, like, $60?
You're a genius, and then we could put it, like, in an NES, and then it'll be for, like, the people that haven't played NES in a long time.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's who it was for, really. It was for the market that hasn't played... Oh my gosh! Why am I dying so much?
So I'm talking? I don't know. I don't have any excuses, guys. Bear with me. What was I saying? Totally forgot what I was saying. Yeah. NES Classic. They're probably gonna make a Super NES Classic. I wouldn't put it past them. I just don't think it's a good idea. Because it's gonna... We'll see what they do. They just came out with a trailer for a new Nintendo 2DS. And I'm like, what are you guys doing? What are you guys doing? You have a portable console. Don't make a new 2DS or 3DS. You push the damn Switch to the moon, people. Push it. Oh my god, this level is destroying me. Alright, do I have any, like, E-tanks? I'm just gonna use that. I don't wanna keep doing this over and over and over and over and over and over and over again! Yeah, Grimling. There should be, like, an RPG kind of console, you know? I wouldn't mind if Square came out with, like, a little console that you could play all the Final Fantasies or something and all their other RPGs on or something, but, you know, people always say, you know, on YouTube, you could just play a ROM and you could just go on your PC and do it. Meh. Which you can, or you can download on your phone or whatever, but, because you could get the Final Fantasies and play them on your phone, so you can get it at the Google Store or iTunes or wherever they're selling it. 2DS XL makes sense, and then it doesn't make sense because, you know, the Nintendo Switch is portable. I mean, that should be the replacement, really. Like, they're combining both their markets. It's funny, this game, you don't need any of their weapons. I could just use the Mega Buster on everybody, it looks like. Who did I just kill last time? Gyro, or whatever his name was? That's a Jesus. That didn't do anything. I think I may have picked the wrong person, but... Yeah. Or is it Gravity? Who did I kill last? I don't even remember. I'll just Mega Buster. Screw it! All Nighter, what's up, man? Hey, thanks for being so positive with me on Twitter, because nobody follows me on Twitter. Nobody follows me on Twitter! Which is fine, you know. It's just like I'm posting on Twitter, and then it's like I get no responses, and then it's like All Nighter. He's replying, he's liking my post, like, alright, man, that's, appreciate it, appreciate the support, you know. Yeah, Twitter, I post on it, but it's hard, because everyone's talking, everyone's saying things, you know, on Twitter. It's very loud on Twitter. Yeah, come on, Nintendo, instead of that damn 2DS, just make more NES Classics. I think people said that in the comments of that trailer. Everyone's like, make NES Classics, Nintendo, you idiots! You know what I mean? Alright, let's see. I'm getting PS trophies on my phone is, like, going off the hook. See, I'm using all these 90 and 2000 slangs off the hook in the house, you know? So bear with me, people. I'm old, okay? Damn it. Yeah, I don't know. All these notifications. Facebook doesn't let you do that at all, you know. They don't even let you turn off notifications. They want to bother you on your phone. Yeah, Belmont, just find, I think it's just the game capsule on Twitter. And then you just see a picture of my big fat head.
AG. You know, it's all AG, the game capsule. I'm on there. I post from the PS4 mostly, like really late at night when I'm playing games, or, you know, if I have something to say about something, I'll say it. You know? Oh, you're older than me? That's good. At least now I'm the youngest one here. Yeah! Well, actually, not the oldest one here, I mean. Oh, Gremlin. Well, you only beat me by, like, a couple years, so it's not that bad. Not that bad. 30s are pretty good, I must say. Being 30 is a different, it's a different feel to it. Belmont, you're 33? I didn't even know that. That's cool. See, I'm 33 also, so I'm like, I'm surprised, yeah, to see you guys being around my age. That's good. You know, sometimes, it's good to talk to people your own age. 30s have been fun so far. Well, fun, I use that, you know. I compare them to my 20s. 20s was just, I don't know. When you're 20, you're dumb, so you just make mistake after mistake. I mean, I'm making mistakes now, too, but you're not as dumb when you're in your 30s, because you've made the mistakes. Hopefully, you've learned from your mistakes, you know. But, you know, you just live life. You're just at a point where you're just like, I'm just going to do what I want, you know, whatever. 20s is just all, it's almost like an extended version of your, like, teens in a way. Like, you think you're grown up, and then it's like, you're still making mistakes. You're still dating the wrong people. You're still, you know, that's me I'm talking about. Now I'm just projecting. But, you know, some of you may be married and found the love of your life, so good for you. That's really great. Some of us, though, have it harder. Just kidding. I don't know. Yeah, 20s are the fun ages, because you could be stupid, you could make mistakes, you can do, you know. You could be those kids are like, I'm gonna go to Europe and, you know, save the world, whatever they do, you know. We're going on a retreat to Europe, and we're gonna help the homeless people there, you know, those people. Or we're gonna go to Spain and learn Spanish, which I probably should have done, that would have been great. Every time people, like, see my last name, it's like, oh, you don't know Spanish? How could you not know Spanish? Meh. Well, because if you're not raised with Spanish, you don't know it. So, you know. James. See, James knows Spanish. What's up, James? How's it going, man? It is around the age 25 you stop hearing how much potential you had, and then it turns into to a loser. Yeah, you don't hear that. When you're in your 30s, you're expected to just be what you're supposed to be. You don't get that, You don't have people look at you with that same viewpoint. So that's actually a very good point. Like, when you go out with girls, you're not gonna hear a girl in, oh god. You're not gonna hear a girl in your 30s say, he has so much potential. He's 33. He's working at Burger King. And he wants to be an astronaut. He has so much potential. Oh, I love him. It's not like that when you're in your 30s. I don't work at Burger King, by the way. I did when I was 18. No, not 18. I was 16 when I worked at Burger King. That was one of my first jobs. But, you don't hear that when you're in your 30s. It's like, oh, I work at Burger King, you know, the girl is like, oh, okay. Alright. Yeah, you need to live your life. Just live your life the way you want to live your life, you know. You'll find someone that wants to be with you and wants to do what you want to, you know. Oh, wow, you want to do this, you want to do that. I love you then. I don't know, we're getting off track. I'm supposed to be talking about video games with you guys, now I'm talking about life stuff. How do I get over there? See, this is where you need that bird. If you had that bird, if you spell Mega Man 5, it can fly over and grab that. I forgot what the bird's name was. F getting married and F having kids, I'm good. Yeah, I'd rather get a dog than have kids. So, oh, sorry, future son or future daughter, if you're watching this in the future, and I said right now that I'd rather have a dog, maybe I just changed my mind by now. You know, you're like, Dad, you didn't want us. Not at 33, son. Not at 33, honey. Get it? Oh, what am I supposed to do now? Thank you, respawn. Except the other one didn't respawn, though. Oh, man. I worked at 7-Eleven when I was 17. Nice, nice, nice. 7-Eleven looks chill, though, but I would always be worried it's gonna get robbed. I don't know. Maybe not, like, in the daytime, but if you're working like those people that work 3 in the morning, I don't know. I'd be kind of, like, on edge. I'd be like, is this guy gonna be the one? Or is the next guy? There we go. Gosh, that took a million years to do. Need an item for that one-up. Yeah, it's a bird, but I forgot the bird's name. Please give me something good. Okay, good. That's good. How many men do I... Oh, this game seems to be giving lives out. Like, just, like, pouring the extra lives on me. It's like, yeah. You want extra lives? Just, like, pour the extra lives on me. I forgot what stage I'm even in right now. Which stage is this? I'm really not paying. I'm like talking and not even talking. I'm talking, not paying attention. I mean, excuse me. Remember Jim Carrey at Liar Liar? Daddy, did you want it a boy or girl? Son, I just wanted to have sex. I don't remember that line. That's a good line. Yeah, that was a good movie. I need to watch that movie again. 2 days ago, I beat a game that took me 25 years to beat. Castlevania Dracula X. Was that on the Genesis? I don't think I played that one. Wait, what kills this guy? I don't remember any of these. Oh, Napalm, I think. No? Yeah. Oh, this guy's dumb. It's like a little kid me, this guy. It's like you go in the boardroom of Capcom back in 1991 or 90, yeah, this game was made in 92, so 91, it's like, all right, guys, we need new robot masters. We brought in these 5-year-olds to help us make the robot masters. Little Jimmy, what would you like to see?
I want like a robot that has like, he's made like a wall, like he's made of bricks, like and all the bricks are stacked really big. And he's a robot brick monster.
Okay, so he's like a stone man. Is that what you're saying, little Jimmy?
Yeah, well, I want like he's like a wall man, like a wall man.
Okay, guys, get on that. We're making stone man. It's made of bricks.
Was Dracula? Dracula X, what am I thinking of? Blood, there was like, blood, was it called Bloodlines or something? I don't remember what it's called. Dracula X was on the Super Nintendo, you're right. Bloodlines is on Genesis, okay. I was thinking of Bloodlines. Yeah, I still didn't play that game, though. I've only played Castlevania 1 through 3, Super Castlevania, and Castlevania 64, and then Lords of Shadow, and I think that's it. Did I play Symphony of the Night? I think I played it, but I didn't beat it. Because I didn't own Symphony of the Night. I think I played it like a friend had it or something. That's a game I need to buy one day. Because I hear it's like one of the best video games of all time. I would probably love it because it's it looks like it's a Metroid type game too. The way the map is laid out. It looks like, anyways. It's a classic. I haven't played it. Shame on me. You can't play everything, people. You know. You only have so many hours in your lifetime. can't play every single game. I mean, I guess you could if you played them for like maybe 5 minutes. I don't know. I wonder if anyone ever did that study or something. Like, can you actually play every video game ever created in your lifetime? I don't think you can. Even Roger Ebert didn't watch every single movie ever made, so... You know, and he had a long, successful life, so... And he adored movies. He loved movies than most people. Can't watch every single... He watched a lot. I mean, don't get me wrong, but... You can't watch them all, people. You cannot watch them all. How do I get through the physics in Super Mario 64? I don't understand that question, sorry, buddy. Oh, is it overrated? Do you think so, Belmont? I still want to play it, though. Just to see what people, you know... I might love it, I might hate it, who knows. Yeah, Super Pokenerd, I don't know what you're talking about. Mang. Clarify your question, Mang. Oh, I want there to be chicken robots, like robot chickens, and then the chickens come out of their chicken stomach. Okay, guys, gotta make chicken mice and chicken robot chickens and robot mice. Little Jimmy said so. Where are we at here? We gotta rush foil finally. I don't think I've been collecting these. I'm not gonna get that last thing, so... Not to possible, like every video on YouTube. I don't know what you guys are talking about now. It's good game, but people go way too insane on it. Yeah, like... Are you hating on Mario 64? During my stream? You're hating on my favorite game of all time? How could you? Super Mario Pokenerd. How could you do that to me? I don't know. It's hard to defend it because I understand that younger people, you play Mario Galaxy and then you go back to Mario 64. It's like, it's kind of hard to play. I understand that. But see, I like the old people. I started from Mario Brothers and then Super Mario Brothers and then Mario Brothers 2, 3, Super Mario World. And then it's like, oh my god, there's a 3D Mario. Holy crap. So, you know, I could still play it. Mario 64 is still absolutely fun for me. Yeah, no, Mario 64 does have bad camera angles. I'm not gonna pretend it doesn't. That was actually one of the big complaints when the game came out. Mario Sunshine also had bad camera angles too. They kinda tried to address that by... If you see Mario through a wall, you kind of see his silhouette. Even that didn't really help, though. What is this guy? I remember fighting this guy during the challenges. You're supposed to beat this guy without using... Who did I just kill? I don't remember. I'm really not paying attention. Oh yeah, the wall guy. Little Jimmy Nino. Is this it? Yeah. God, it's not even doing anything. I can't even do anything. I mean, I'm pressing the button, but nothing's happening. I don't get it. Ugh, getting killed. Yeah, 2D games hold up for sure. Like, you can go back to Link to the Past, and it's still, like, wonderful. But Mario 64, I don't know how you can hate it, though. It's still fun, I don't know. That was, like, that and Croc were the first 3D video game, so, I mean, you gotta hand it to Nintendo for making such a game that well when it was almost unknown for developers. It was a brand new thing. It was an innovative game. Oh my gosh, I can't die from this guy. I might have to use an E-Tank, because, you know, I'm gonna be lazy, guys, and I just wanna stream. I don't wanna... My gosh, this sucks. This weapon sucks. Yeah, I don't wanna do it again. E-tank it. This is not like one of those, like, I want to show you my skills, guys, run. I need to show you how good I am at Mega Man. I'm gonna have a only buster, never get hit by anything run, you know? Those guys, I don't know how they do it. Oh, I see. He's invincible. I'm not even paying attention. There we go. Sunshine, I think, is the worst 3D Mario. I've said that for years. You know, you've gone to AG Entertainment on my old channel, and I said Mario Sunshine isn't that good. It's good, but it's not great. You got Charge Kick. Oh boy, I got Charge Kick. Oh, password, guys. I need a notebook to write down the password. I used to have pages and pages of passwords for Mega Man when I was a kid. All this crap. I drew up that whole, like, little... the rows and columns, and like, okay, blue, B, I put a B with that circle, and then R for red, R, E2. I guess I could have just done that. That would have been easier. 8, but I was, you're a little kid. You're a little kid, so you draw out the whole password instead of just writing A2, A6, B4, you know. So what? A train would probably kill a crystal, right? What do you think? I don't remember. Or a wave. This game is all over the place. The old Mega Mans, you can tell. Oh, okay. A saw could kill wood, because a saw could cut through wood, so I could use, Metal Man to kill Wood Man. In this game, it's like, a train is gonna kill the water guy? Okay, I guess. But yeah, Mario Sunshine. In that video I made, I was complaining about the voice acting. They should have never had voice acting in Mario. Because
Bowser! Oh, my name is Bowser, and I'm gonna get him.
And then it's like, Bowser Jr. is like,
Oh, Mario, I'm gonna frame you.
And they're like, what the heck are you doing, Nintendo? Oh, crap. Forgot about this part. You only beat Mega Man 9? Well, Mega Man 9's a good game. I wish Mega Man 9 was on PS4. I mean, I don't know what they're... See, Capcom is just... Kill me, Capcom, you're killing me. It's like, we have Mega Man 9, but we don't want to release it on newer consoles. They'll probably have a Mega Man Legacy 2 or something, I bet. This is kind of similar to Mega Man 9. That female Robot Master had this in her level. The bubbles. Oh my gosh. Woman Man. So stupid, Woman Man. Laughing at my own stupid jokes. Oh my god! Forgot about the spikes. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? Rush Jet, I guess? I don't know, guys. I don't know. I don't remember. Oh my gosh. Do I have it? No. Now, is this the Rush Jet that can actually fly everywhere? No, it just goes straight. That's stupid.
That's absolutely stupid!
We'll just go across. So, do any of you guys have the Nintendo Switch? Anybody? Anybody at all? It's fun! It just needs more games right now. It's very... slim pickings. What's out right now? Bomberman? Oh, I always thought this level was weird. Like, this part for Mega Man game. But this is like... this reminds me of Battletoads. What is that? Binding of Isaac? I have that on my computer, so I don't know if I would want to get that. Bomberman, Binding of Isaac, I Am Setsuna, they got some Neo Geo games on the Nintendo shop, eShop. I don't know, it's very slim pickings. The Wii U had a better launch lineup. Well, I guess it didn't, because Breath of the Wild is like a triple-A, five-star WoW game, so... What did the Wii U have? New Super Mario Bros. U? That's okay. It was passable. It's an enjoyable game to have. But it's not like a big... It's not a Mario 64. It's not like, oh my gosh, I need to get this because I've never played a 3D Mario game. You know. That's what you need. You need something like a Zelda Breath of the Wild to launch your console. Splatoon is coming out in the summer. The second one, right? So that's coming. Look at James telling me how to play the game after I'm past that part! Come on, James! I'm already past the bubbles part. You don't have to tell me how to do it when I did it. I used my rush. I used my dog. I used my little puppy dog to get me across. That's why he's there. That's why Rush was made for me. Dr. Light said, Mega Man, we need you. We're gonna give you a little dog. And the dog. Wait, that's not the voice. What was the voice I used last time? Like, little Mega Man. It was from the cartoon. Remember, he's like, oh no, Mega Man 8. He's like, little Mega Man, we need to make you a dog. I don't remember the voice now. I was doing it in the last video I did. Make me a puppy dog so you can go across bubbles without straining yourself. Oh, thanks, Dr. Light. I appreciate you getting me a dog that can make me jump higher. Why don't you just make my boots do that? Oh, because we need to have a dog so we can sell more merchandise to kids. Oh! I get it. I bet Mario Maker will come out on Switch, but it'll probably be a port. We'll see. We will see. How many lives do I have? 4. I could die again. That's fine. I'll die. So, nobody owns Nintendo Switch? Nobody? I asked. You're getting it when Splatoon 2 comes out. How come I'm seeing people's comments in the video? I don't know. YouTube is all over the freaking place. What did I get? Crash Kick or whatever this is called? What does this do? It's not even doing anything. Oh, it's a slide? That's dumb. That's so dumb, guys! As a kid, did you ever see any adults your parents' age play video games at the arcade? Oh, hell yeah. Actually, I did, definitely. I remember watching a guy play Pac-Man. He was probably older than my parents. So when I was a little kid, I was probably like 8 years old, 7 years old, maybe, yeah. And I remember watching this guy play Pac-Man. And I'd never seen anybody play Pac-Man like this guy. And this guy had to be in his 50s. He was probably a pro. Like, I'm not even messing around. He was probably a pro Pac-Man player. And he didn't even know he was a pro. Like, I watched him... Like, he would... I don't know, guys. I can't even explain it. He would, like, psych out the ghosts. He would have all of them follow him. Like, all the ghosts would be in a pack, all together, following him. And he would wait. He would have Pac-Man, like, hit, like, the side of the screen and just wait for them all to come. And then he gets the pellet. And then he eats them all, like, at once. Like... And he did it every time, and he was like, he rarely died. I don't even think I remember seeing him die. He probably was like a pro. He didn't even think, like, he'd even know he was a pro, but I was like, that's how I kind of learned how to play Pac-Man, by watching that guy. I'm still not as good as him at Pac-Man, but Pac-Man is a hard game. I downloaded Pac-Man on PS4, and it's supposed to be like an arcade... Oh god, of course. It's supposed to be an arcade, perfect port, but the controls are off in it. And it seems like the difficulty is spiked. Like, the Pac-Man in the arcade is not as hard as Pac-Man on PS4. So I don't know what Namco did on their home version. It seems like the difficulty is higher on the home version than the arcade. No, there were adults. There were definitely adults. But the games that kids played were usually mature games. I remember adults playing Gauntlet. Gauntlet was like late 80s, early 90s. I remember my dad liked Gauntlet. I think I played Gauntlet with him when I was little. Oh my gosh, really? Oh, I should use that star thing. That's what I'm not doing right. But then when, like, Mortal Kombat came out, it was mostly kids. Like, kids were attracted to it. And that's why the whole ESRB thing came about. Mortal Kombat, Doom, Night Trap. These were mature-rated games that made parents go insane. Like, oh my gosh! I can't believe that my kids are playing these games, even though I bought them the games. Like, I don't get people. So then the ESRB was born, because of Mortal Kombat, Night Trap, Doom, all these mature-rated games that came out back in the day. Oh god, don't die. Okay, please don't die. I got so far. I'm gonna jump right after that pulse. There we go. So, you know how nowadays it's like people always say, oh yeah, Call of Duty's for kids, you know? And they say that because when you play Call of Duty, a mature rated game that has killing and blood and people getting shot, you go on the mics online, you know, oh, I'm gonna play Call of Duty, and then there's, you get killed by someone, and then it's like, yeah, get on, bitch! And then I just laugh, I'm like, oh, hilarious to me. I don't know. I'm dying a lot in this. It's kind of embarrassing. One life left. I used all my star power. I'm gonna probably just go across with Rush Jet. Because I don't want to die anymore. Yeah, I get cursed out on Grand Theft Auto the most, probably. By kids and by adults. You know, and I use the term adults very loosely, people. You know, people call me the N-word on mic. I'm like, okay. Alright, hopefully I don't get knocked off, though. You get knocked off? That's stupid. That's unbelievable. This is my last life on this. I'm sorry, guys, that I'm performing so poorly for you. So poorly. But yeah, Night Trap is coming out for the PS4. There was a trailer that dropped the other day for Night Trap, which came out on the Sega CD. 32X, I believe. Coming out on PS4! I'm done. That was it for me. Oh, game over. That's freaking embarrassing. But we will go on. But Night Trap's having a 25th anniversary edition if you never played it. It was pretty much the first Five Nights at Freddy's, excuse me. You're looking at cameras, you know, trying to stop the bad guys from killing these girls in this house. I want to get it. I don't think I ever played it, but I watched, Watched. I was about to say I watched YouTube videos back in the 90s. I watched a YouTube video back then and saw Night Trap. No, in video game magazines, I always see Night Trap, and I always used to think, like, wow, how does it have such good graphics? You know, because you don't understand, like, they just use full motion video. Oh my gosh, making me, like, have cramps this part. I don't know why I'm doing so bad at this part. Okay. Oh, good. Thanks, Mommy. I love you. You are not watching this, and you don't know English, but I love you. What? James, you're going crazy! She got you Conquer instead. I don't know what you guys are talking about right now. And I don't know what James is talking about. James, what are you talking about, man? I don't know what you're saying. Now, Sega CD had some good games. Snatcher was a good game. She bought me Conquer. She thought I was a kid friend because... Oh, I get it. Yeah, it happens. It happens. Oh god, don't die. Oh, now there's... Let's see. Does this go up? No, go across. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. James got Killer Instinct Gold, but his mom exchanged it for Conquer. Oh, I see. Well, Killer Instinct Gold... Well, it was Killer Instinct Gold T for teen, right? So... Yeah, I guess she made a mistake. But Conquer wasn't that bad. I know it had sexual innuendo and stuff, but... I could handle that at, you know... Well, if you're a kid, I guess it's different. I bought Conquer when I was, like, in high school. So, yeah, when you're in high school, it's not a big deal. It had, like... Yeah, sexual innuendo, that's about it. And he cursed, but... It's because a little squirrel did it, that's the bad thing. You know, that was the bad thing about it. A little cutesy squirrel was cursing, and he was narcissistic, and he wanted money, and he had, like, a... You know, sexy squirrel girlfriend. Oh god, I'm gonna die again. What was her name? Barry?
Barry. Gotta go home to Barry.
It's such a fun game. And singing poop, yeah. So it was like, you know, immature humor, really. That's what I kind of saw it as. But, oh, you can't have a talking squirrel saying bad things. His parents will get crazy.
My little kid is playing a game where a squirrel is cursing.
I don't know. And then parents will let their kids watch the Kardashians. So, you know, it's like, people don't know what they're doing. I don't know. The world is just upside down. All over the place. This Rush Coil is like a dumb version. It's like you have to jump after it jumps. Come on, Dr. Light, why did you change it up? The old one was perfectly fine. Damn it. Alright, I'm drinking this E-Tank. Gulp. What is the M for? I don't even remember. Oh, it fills up your, fills up the powers, right? Of all the Robot Master weapons you have. And you're not crazy, AG. Don't hurt my feelings. Come on, James. You're a grown-ass man. You can take it. I missed that one. It was the V. And there's that V. That's right, James. I'm crazy. Don't worry about it.
We're all a little crazy, aren't we? Yep. Conquer the cane.
I remember when Conquer was gonna be called Something Tails, or Seven Tails, or something, and it looked like another Banjo-Kazooie. I was like, come on, Nintendo, we don't need any more... Or I guess it was Rare. Come on, Rare, we don't need any more of these freaking cutesy platformers anymore. And they changed it up, so that was good. That was good. Wait, this is not what I killed. Who kills this guy? The wave does not do it.
I don't remember.
Crash kick killed the wave guy, so the wave guy should kill this guy. It's not working. That's weird. Is it this? Oh, I gotta try out all of them. Oh, is this? Why is it this? I killed this guy a long time ago. I think I just did the wrong order, huh? Oh god, don't die. Please don't die. Oh god, did I use it? Oh my gosh, I was sweating, guys. I was sweating and I was like, oh my gosh, I might die. And I didn't. I lived to tell another day. Let's go, Mega Man. To Wily's castle. This is to you. Alright, Super Mario Poke Nerd.
You got Crystal Eye.
Crystal Light? The drink? Oh my gosh! Proto Man is the boss? Ah! That was kids back in the 90s.
But he's Mega Man's brother! How could he be the boss?
Come on, people! It's a trick! Proto Man's not a bad guy, okay? He's not a bad guy.
Proto Man's your brother.
Your brother of arms. So, let's see now. What else is going on in the gaming world? So I talked about the 2DS, the new one coming out. Yes, Nintendo Switch. You know, Nintendo stopping production with that NES Classic. Idiots. I love you, Nintendo, but sometimes you're an idiot. Just to let you know. Because everybody wants it, and you're like, oh, everybody wants what we want to sell? Let's not sell it. Okay. We're just gonna move on now. Thanks. Still love you, Nintendo. What else is going on in the gaming world? Little Nightmares is gonna come out for PS4. I don't know what that is, but it's coming out. It's coming out. Talked about Night Trap coming out, which is cool. That's coming out from Limited Run Games, and, you know, they're the guys that make a very small amount of copies of physical releases. You know, they did the physical release for Shantae and those Shantae games. So that's pretty cool. Let's see. Oh, well, let's talk about just briefly about my channel. You're gonna be seeing me a lot more very soon because I've just been gearing up for a full-blown return. You know, I've been making videos again, which is good. The videos are only getting like 25, 50 views. Doesn't bother me. It's like it's tough, you know. If you're trying to get into the YouTube game at this point of time, oh, you dumb dog. It's difficult, right? Or if you start over, so that's not really a big deal. I'm just glad to be making videos again. And what is this dog doing? Okay, what do I do? There we go. Yeah, you're gonna see me more often. There'll be more Game Capsule TV videos, and I think I'm gonna start talking about my opinions on stuff again, like I used to. And then, you know, make top 10s, and I'll have a variety of different videos, and I'll see what kind of catches on and what doesn't. You know, it's all a testing thing. You know, and then down the road, I can do a podcast, and I can do more things, so I'll let you know as we go on. You should try to reach out to other slightly bigger channels. Yes, I'll be doing that too. I don't know, yeah. We can do collabs, maybe we can stream together. You know, that's a great idea. I did consider that, so that's on the to-do list. I just don't know when I'll do it. Yeah, because if you want to try to reach out to the huge YouTubers, you know, I don't know what they would want, because they don't want to collab with a person with 900 subs. They're going to be like, okay, who are you? You know? Oh, not this garbage. Can I just fly across? Let's see. Sorry, I might need some concentration for this, guys. Let's see if I can get across just with the dog.
Oh my god, doggy!
Yes! That was lucky. Good doggy. Oh, bad doggy.
Oh!
Oh, you know what I'll do? Okay, we'll put the doggy on that. It's like I'm just calling him doggy. I know his name is Rush. Is that the one I need to go on? Oh, he doesn't go on though. Is that stupid? Okay. That's all I needed to do. Let's see. Also, I know I'm streaming late. I want to figure out, like, what's the better time to stream. Because, you know, I understand people might be on the East Coast, and what time is it over there? 11, 12, 1 in the morning, almost 2 in the morning on the East Coast. So if you guys are living on the East Coast of the USA, you know, I know James, you're from Mexico, so I don't know where in Mexico you are, but if you're like on the, you know, if your time zone is different, is what I'm trying to say, I would like to find a better time zone for you guys instead of, you know, unless you guys like being up late, I don't know. I watch streamers sometimes at really late at night. This is hard. Let's see. And I hear, like, the big time is to do it in the afternoon. But, I don't know. We will see. 11:45? Okay, so you're probably around my time. Or actually, I think I'm at 10 o'clock. So you're an hour ahead of me. Oh god, don't die. I don't want to die. I might die. I am fortunately unemployed at the moment, so any time is good for me. Well, it's okay, man. You gotta just get back on the horse and find that job. Find the job. Plenty of jobs out there. I know a lot of people like to say, but the economy is hard, and I just can't do it. Like, no, you can do it. It's just gonna take time. You know, you gotta have some patience. Apply to whatever you can do. You know, do what you gotta do. Don't let people make you feel bad about it either. They're just joiks, bunch of joiks. All right, this is getting annoying. Is this M gonna help me? Let's see. Cool. Hello, Neslo! Neslo in the house! See? I'm just being old and 90s. Raise the roof for Neslo! Neslo, we're playing Mega Man 5. Proto Man is the boss of this game! I didn't even know that! No, I'm kidding. And we're talking about a whole bunch of things going on in the gaming world. Nintendo Switch, new Nintendo 2DS, what? You know, new games coming out for PS4, like the Night Trap 25th anniversary. Final Fantasy XII is getting a remake for PS4, if you guys didn't hear about that. I don't know, I never played Final Fantasy XII. So I'll probably pick that up down the line. And that's the one thing I like about the PS4. I know people complain about the remasters and everything, but it gives me a chance to play games I never got to play, you know? Because I was playing Nintendo stuff, you know, before PS4. I was mainly a Nintendo guy, right? So having remasters and remakes and bringing GTA 5 to PS4 and Last of Us and all these other games, and of course my beloved NES classics like Mega Man, it's cool. It's cool to play games you missed, games you miss, and much more. So yeah, Final Fantasy XII is coming out for PS4 eventually. So that's pretty cool. So we're gonna have on PS4, Final Fantasy X, Final Fantasy XII, Final Fantasy X-2, Final Fantasy XIV Online, and Final Fantasy XV. It seems like Square is, they're trying to release all of the Final Fantasies because they're preparing for the Final Fantasy VII Remake. And if I'm assuming that Final Fantasy XV brought in some new fans, so they're gonna be like, well, we need to now show the new fans what we used to be. So they're gonna bring back the old games. Hopefully, they bring back Final Fantasy VIII and IX, like at least put them on the PlayStation Store, or the very least. And that'd be cool. You can have like the majority of the Final Fantasy games on PS4. Hell, they can do a Final Fantasy collection, 1 through 6. They can do that on one disc. You know? That would be pretty cool, too. This is not reaching. I don't know why I'm shooting it. Oh, you have the new 2DS? Do you like it? That's a lot of Final Fantasy, definitely. Friend showed me the new 2DS. I thought it was fake. I saw the video on my playlist, you know, my subscription box, and I thought it was fake. I was like, new 2DS! And then I saw it was from Nintendo. I was like, oh, you guys. You gotta help the Switch out. Don't make something else to compete with it. I'm hearing, I don't know about, not stories, but I'm hearing rumors that kids are like, you know, parents are afraid to let their kids take the Switch to school and it's too big to hold and stuff. So people are saying there might be a Nintendo Switch Mini in the future. Maybe, who knows, you know, I wouldn't put it past Nintendo to have a Nintendo Switch Mini, you know. We got a new 2DS, no one asked for that, but we got that, so. Where am I at? Rush Coil. Oh my god. That was pathetic. I'm gonna play them all. I definitely would play all the way in the beginning, really. Come on. First, I'm gonna finish all the Kingdom Hearts. Yeah, see, I haven't played Kingdom Hearts either, so I probably should get that down the road. It's too many games to play, people. It's too many games to play. I can't keep up with all of them. You know, and I have games in my library I haven't even played yet, so I have Last of Us Remastered. How did I say that? Last of Us Remastered. I had the Last of Us Remastered. I have it. It's right in front of me, actually, in my pile of games, but it's in the original packaging. See that? Last of Us. Still in its packaging. Still in the shrink wrap, because I have not opened it yet, and I've had it probably since last August. So I just haven't delved into it yet. I got it for free. Well, not free, but Target was doing this thing where it was like, oh, buy two, get one free. So I got like Mortal Kombat, Jurassic World, and Last of Us. So one of them was free. I'm gonna die again. That's really sad. How do I keep dying in this game? It's so easy, and I'm just dying over and over. I miss the good times at elementary, looking at all our Pokemon Game Boys. I can't share that experience. My experience was playing Tetris and Super Mario Land on Game Boy, so it shows what era of Game Boy you were at. I was in the beginning. Pokemon came out in 99, so I was in high school by then, and I wasn't... I remember watching the Pokemon cartoon, but I never got into the games. I never really got into Pokemon. Even when people were going crazy last summer for the Pokemon Go game, I didn't even want to download it. I was like, eh, I can live without it.
I can live without it, guys. And everyone's like,
no! You gotta play it with us. We gotta go here, and we're gonna go to the gym, and we're gonna get some Pokemon, and then the sand you guys. And I'm like,
nah, it's okay. It's alright. I gotta...
No, you gotta play. We play some Pokemon. We go to the mall, and we're gonna go to... We're gonna go to the park and get some Pokemon, some gyms, the Pokemon gyms, you know?
I don't know. I don't know who's talking like that. My sister? I don't know. So. Game Boy Color? Yeah, I had the brick Game Boy. Oh my gosh! I'm not good at this game right now. Okay, maybe I'll talk a little less. You guys talk in the chat and I'll read what you have to say. Let me just concentrate just a little tiny bit so I can get past this one part. I'm getting stupid! I'm not blaming the game, I'm blaming myself. I'm not totally focused. DualShock battery is low! Oh my gosh. Better charge that. Alright. Controller charged. Who plays Overwatch? Do you guys like Overwatch? I've been playing that too. I'm not good competitively. I guess you're supposed to be like level 4,000 to be competitively like amazing in that. I'm like, I think I'm like 1,800 or something. So, just trying to be good at Overwatch, but everyone's just so good in it. Anyway, you get stuck on bad teams, so that always harms your score and whatever. Sometimes people just throw the game. That's like, that makes me mad. I don't rage or anything, it's kind of annoying. I'm like, come on. I don't know, I don't think competitive is as fun as just playing it for fun. Because there's people that play it competitively, competitively, they play it competitively, there we go. And they don't have any fun. They're just mad on the mics and yelling and stuff. Like, calm yourself down and enjoy it. Game Boy Pocket. I just had the old Game Boy. And then that was it for me. I guess the Nintendo Switch is like the first handheld I've had since the original Game Boy back in the day. You know, last gen games I have played. You haven't played Overwatch? Well, you know, it's another first-person shooter, it's just colorful and, you know, got superhero kind of motif going on. That's where I died that other time, huh? Alright, what is this? Okay, go down. Alright, okay, good. Belmont, do you have current-gen... Well, you obviously have a PlayStation. Or do you have a PlayStation? I guess I can't say obviously. I'm assuming you're watching it on the console. I usually watch streams from the PS4, so I guess that's why I thought that. But do you have PS4, or Xbox One, or a Switch, or a Wii U, or... I'm just gonna name all the consoles. A PS3, an Xbox 360, Nintendo Wii, a PS2, a GameCube, an Xbox... I'm just getting annoying now. More annoying than usual. Let's see now. Okay, well, I'm not dying that much right now, so that's good. Is this a secret over here? Let's see now. Wasn't there, like, a smaller Game Boy? There's Game Boy Pocket, and there was, like, Game Boy Micro also, right? I always wanted to get that, just for the novelty of it. They probably have them on eBay. Oh my god, am I gonna die again? I don't wanna die again. I'm just gonna use it. I do have a PS4, yes. Too little. I also have a PS4, and, yeah, I'd probably just get it for the novelty. Game Boy Micro. What is this crap?
box? Man, Capcom was not trying with this game. So, I want like a boss, and he just like walks back and forth, but he has like a force field around him, and the force field, like, it spins around and around and around, so it protects him sometimes, but not always, and then he just starts running faster when he gets hurt. Okay, little Jimmy, we'll work on that boss too. What does he look like? I don't know, he just looks like a robot, you know, like, he looks like a robot. Like Mega Man? No, like a robot. Okay. We'll get right on it, little Jimmy. And make that little robot. N-Gage. Yeah, I remember N-Gage. I never played it, but I remember seeing it in the stores. I think I remember seeing it at GameStop. That was a long time ago.
I'm losing my voice, you guys.
This reminds me of those things in Ninja Turtles. Do you remember that skateboard level? Oh, the helicopters and that skateboard level in the Ninja Turtles arcade game. Those remind me of. So yeah, we're still in Proto Man's castle right now. Proto Man kidnapped Dr. Light, I guess, and it's all a swerve, people. You know, Proto Man is not a bad guy. Okay, getting mind controlled. You know, Dr. Light, who is Mega Man's daddy, his poppy, got kidnapped, and, we know Dr. Wily's behind this, we just have to know, but, you know, maybe back then, people were tricked, like, in Mega Man 4, Dr. Cossack, it's like, oh my gosh, Dr. Wily's not the boss, you know, that's kind of like in Twilight Princess, like, oh, Zant's the boss? Wow, no Ganon? And then, of course, there's Ganon. There's always Ganon, people. Even in the Skyward Sword, you know, they just called Ganon something else. We'll call him Demise, you know. It's still Ganon, though. Because Demise is like the spirit, the evil of Ganon. So, that's where Ganon originated. Even though Ocarina of Time explained that Ganon was born from the Gerudo, but let's just change the story a million times, okay? Because the Gerudo only have a male baby every 1,000 years, and Ganon was one of those babies! But then, Skyward Sword changed the story and said, no, Demise's spirit went into the Ganon baby. I don't know. Who knows? Nintendo doesn't know what they're doing sometimes. They're just making it up as they go along. That's what I really believe. You know? And then when like the fans start putting the pieces together, Nintendo's like, oh, like this fans are pretty smart. Let's use their timeline and just run with it. You know. I'm gonna just talk about Zelda. Hopefully you guys know something about Zelda. But yeah, we should talk about Mega Man and Mega Man 5. Yeah, it's really sad that I know. Nah, it's not sad. It's Zelda, people. You better know about Zelda. Can't call yourself a fan. Oh my god. I could just use Rush right now, but I'm trying to be a pro. Oh, what the hell happened? You know this thing? This thing on the PlayStation controller? This messes me up more than anything else. I wish you could disable it when you play a game sometimes, because sometimes when I play like Mortal Kombat or Overwatch and I press that or what other game it affects, either pauses the game or messes me up. I wish it could be disabled or locked or something, so when you press it, it doesn't actually do anything. Am I gonna die again? Yes. Yes, that's a yes. I guess that's a yes! And I'm tired of dying. Because it would be nice to beat the game under 2 hours, but, you know. Oh, I'm supposed to use the rush coil right there. That's dumb. Dumb.
No, AG, it's because you're not good at the game.
Oh, man. I love Mega Man. Even the bad games. This game is not really bad, it's okay. Mega Man 6 is bad. And we'll be playing that next time, guys, on the Game Capsule TV live. Here on the Game Capsule TV on YouTube. The Game Capsule TV is brought to you by AG. That's me. I don't know what I'm saying right now. I wish I had sponsors. Brought to you by Nabisco. Ritz Crackers and Cheez-Its. Your favorite gaming snack, Nabisco. What is their tagline? Do they even have a tagline? Yeah, Ocarina of Time is the best game ever made, guys. I love Ocarina of Time. I need to replay that one day. It was my favorite game for the longest time until, like, I just kind of played Mario 64 way more. So, I kind of came to the conclusion I must like Mario 64 hell of a lot if I keep playing it over and over and over again. Want to try something harder? What about Angry Video Game Nerd Adventures? It's literally Mega Man on steroids. Is that on PS4? Maybe I'll try that. What is this? Another one of those dumb robots? Oh god, it's shooting like... shooting balls at me. Shooting balls at me in the face. Oh, that sucks. I get frozen. Slide! Do I have an E-Tank? I do. Do I use it, though? No, I didn't hurt him enough to use it. Let's figure out at least what weapon kills him. And then we can continue on. Let's see. No. No. Or no, that's it. That's it.
I can't keep dying like this.
Yeah, when I did that Drawn to Death video last time, I did a stream with playing Drawn to Death, and I was using that microphone on my head. It was, audio was garbage. That's why I had to take the video down. I was, like, not happy with that. I was like, this cannot be, official video in this playlist, because the audio is just... it's just trash. People trash. Oh god, don't get hit by that. No. Can I get out of that? No. Please don't die. Oh my god. Oh my god. No, I can't do it. I gotta do it. I don't wanna die again. Okay. I guess I wouldn't have died, but whatever. So yeah, James, I might play that. If it's on PS4, I'll try it out. I'm thinking about playing Mighty No. 9 after I'm done with Mega Man, because everyone's saying how bad it is, and I want to see how bad it really is. Because then, since I compared, we can compare it to all the Mega Man games I played in a row, and then it's like, oh... it's bad. Or, hey, it's not that bad. I don't fully trust what everyone says all the time because... oh, this is kind of cool. Because, excuse me, I didn't even finish my sentence. People will say, oh, this game is bad. Oh, I can't even use Rush Jet. That sucks. Rush Coil. And then everyone will just jump on the bandwagon without even playing the game. So everyone will be like, yeah, Mighty No. 9 is terrible. Oh, yeah, did you play it? No, but my friend did, and he said it was bad. So it's like, I want to play it for myself and see how bad it really is. You know what I mean, man? Alright, then we, yeah. What's happening here? It's not that bad. It's just not what people expected. See, that's what I figured.
And I understand if you paid for that, like if you did that Kickstarter or whatever, and you weren't happy with it, then I guess you... I mean, I guess it makes sense that you're mad, but... whatever. Oh, do I have to shoot that? I guess I do. I don't know, I'm having a brain fart at this part. Do I keep that there? I don't remember. Okay, so I can jump up there. Can jump up there. I can make it there. Okay, so I have to shoot it and just jump really fast? Yeah, I guess so. Alright. Okay, let's see. I'm so afraid it's gonna all fall on me. I still can't use rush, huh? Dang. Oh god, no. So basically, you just have to shoot all of them, you just can't get killed. Okay, of course. Alright, I think I'm okay now. Okay. Guys, anything new in the chat? Let's see. Oh my god, it's Proto Man! What's happening? Oh, damn. Oh my god, it's Proto Man again! What the heck? That wasn't really Proto Man? It's just another stupid robot boss? Little Jimmy made up? What? Oh god. Well, Super Robot Boss is actually hard. Okay. Sorry, call it Stupid Robot Boss, and then it's just started whooping my ass. Whooping my ass. Oh, what? I gotta do this again? Come on, Capcom. You're killing me here. Oh my god. You're killing me, Capcom. You're killing me. You're killing me. You couldn't just start me at the boss right in front of the door. Nope. You gotta do it all over again. See, that's old school, people. That's old school. They just make you do it all over again. Okay. Oh god, don't go too crazy. See how fast I did that this time? Because I know what to do. Alright. I wish I hadn't died at that boss, though. I want to keep going. Okay, let's find a weapon that kills him. Let's see. What would kill this monster? This robot, excuse me. P-stone? Piss-stone? Let's see. Oh, this is that stupid weapon. No, that doesn't do it. G-hold? J-hold? K-kick? Let's see. No, don't use that stupid weapon. Star crash? Let's see. Nope. That doesn't do it. How about we'll wave? No. That doesn't do it. What about the Gat Attack? Is that it? No. What about Saka Eye? The Eye? Oh. No. No. What about Nabomb? No. No. What the? Fudge. Fudge. I said fudge. Then the YouTube censors will be all over this video. Flagged for saying fudge. But fudge is delicious. I am sucking right now. See, people are leaving the chat and the stream because they're like, oh, cool, Mega Man 5. Oh, this guy sucks. We don't want to watch him. I gotta prove how good I am at games, guys, so people will watch my streams. I gotta prove that I'm the best video game player of all time! But I'm not. But I am. White chocolate fudge. I don't know. Any kind of dessert right now sounds kind of good, to be honest.
feel like having ice cream. Doesn't that sound good right now? Ice cream sounds good. This is so dramatic. This is like Metroid. Super Metroid, I mean. Fighting the Mother Brain. L. Yeah, I'll take that L. So I guess this boss doesn't die from anything. So I'm just gonna shoot it with the Mega Buster. Okay, I'm gonna concentrate somewhat on this guy, so... I really don't want to do it again. Oh god, I'm getting my ass kicked still. Oh, I don't want to do this again. Oh my gosh. I'm sucking a pickle right now. I don't know what that means. Now it's getting annoying. I'm kind of getting annoyed. Kinda. Just kind of getting annoyed. I'm doing so poorly on this right now. Alright. Full concentration. Alright. Just give me a couple minutes, guys. Couple minutes. Yeah. Aw. It's like full concentration. I'm stupid. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna wait for his projectiles there. Oh, damn it. For some reason, the jump was delayed there. Alright. That should not have been as hard as it was. I was just messing up. Did I beat the game? No. You've done well, Mega Man. I never expected you to defeat my powerful Dark Man robot. Until now, I have I'm changing the voice now. Until now, I have managed to frame Proto-Man for my crimes. But now the real Proto-Man has appeared and spoiled my plan. Dr. Light is a captive in my lab. Come if you dare. I don't know what his voice would sound like. Ooh, yeah. Easy as hell. Shut up, James! I wasn't concentrating before. Dude, I can't believe Wily's the boss. I can't believe it. Unbelievable. Who saw that coming? I thought it was Proto-Man! Wow! Wily again. Six times in a row? Was it five times? Sorry, we're not me. I jumped ahead. Mega Man 5, people. Five times in a row! Oh, spiked right in my butt. I can't believe it, guys. Wily. Dr. Wily again! I'm blown away. I need to go on Reddit in the Mega Man forums and just... This is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Wait, no, go this way. There you go, buddy. That's a good boy. Oh, almost died there, too. Oh, man. But yeah, James, it is a twist. I can't believe it. It's unbelievable. Wow, Dr. Wily again. Unbelievable storytelling, Capcom. I just can't handle it. I can't handle it. I mean, it was like, oh, Proto-Man turned bad? Like, I was intrigued. And then all of a sudden, Dr. Wily came back. Wow. Whew.
even though that was the same storyline of Mega Man 4! When everyone thought it was Dr. Cossack, and Dr. Cossack was just... he was just a ruse. He was just a red herring. Dr. Wily, once again. So, I don't know, people. I don't know. I still love these games. It's not about the storytelling. They just need to give you a reason to go from A to B. It's just, it's the princess getting kidnapped thing. It's just, oh, Mario needs to go somewhere for a reason. Why does he need to go? Oh, because the princess got kidnapped. Okay, now Mario has a reason to go. So then Mario goes on an adventure. God damn it. I know you could argue, though. See, when Nintendo tried something different... Oh my gosh, Mario was framed! He painted the whole town! Try something different, but don't make it dumb. Okay. No, it was cutesy. I like Mario Sunshine okay. Bowser Jr. is what I had a problem with back then. I didn't... Bowser Jr. was gonna... What the heck? I'm gonna die. Because I grew up with the Koopa kids, you know? Ludwig, Lemmy, Wendy, you know, Morton. And then Nintendo's like, screw them, Bowser has a new son. And I was like, Bowser Jr., what? When did Bowser Jr. happen? Where is Mrs. Bowser? I want to know where Mrs. Bowser is. Because if Bowser's having new kids, there is a Bowser female somewhere. There's a Mrs. Bowser somewhere. And I want to see her. Am I going to die? Don't die. Don't die. Okay. I want to see a Lady Bowser. Because you can't just have a Bowser Jr. out of nowhere, Nintendo. Okay. Alright. Just putting that out there. You know. Unless, you know, Peach really is Bowser Jr.'s mom. I mean, you know, she does spend a lot of time with Bowser, you know what I'm saying, people? Bowser's kidnapped her enough. It's almost like she likes to get kidnapped. It's almost like, oh, no, Bowser, don't kidnap me. I'll just walk on the airship. You don't have to tie me up or anything. I'll just go along with you. I don't know. She could be cheating on Mario and just pretending, so, you know. To be faking it. I don't know. Seems kind of fishy to me, people. You know, Peach might have a thing for Bowser. I saw in the Mario Odyssey trailer that Bowser's trying to marry her. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Bowser's obviously in love with her. Bowser Jr. could be Peach's son in real life. In real life. James, don't give me that crap. I will slap your freaking face. Back in 1990, you open the Super Mario Bros. 3 instruction book, and it shows the Koopa kids in a circle. And it says, these are Bowser's kids! Kids! Bowser's kids! So I don't care what Miyamoto is saying, I don't care what... You can't just tell me they're Bowser's kids and then take it back and say they're adopted now. That's, a joke. This is what I care about at age 33. Bowser's kids. You are not the father. Bowser, you are not the father. What? Bowser's not the father? But it said in the instruction book.
So blame Miyamoto. Yeah, I do blame Miyamoto. He's keep changing his mind for no reason. I know what you're talking about. Oh my god, I am dying so much in this game. It's incredibly embarrassing because this game is not hard. Yeah, Miyamoto changed his mind. I don't know what they're doing in Nintendo. They're eating some mushrooms themselves along with Mario. That's all I have to say about that. They're taking some mushrooms of their own. Trying to somewhat concentrate because I don't want to keep dying at these dumb bosses. This is an easy boss and I died from it. That's just... that's embarrassing. Absolutely embarrassing. Oh, man. So, yeah, tonight, Friday night, you know, playing Mega Man. I guess now it's Saturday, huh? Saturday morning. I don't know. Video game storylines, you know. I know they're getting better and stuff, but Nintendo ones, they're just Nintendo. They're for kids. They're geared towards kids. I just don't understand one day saying, oh, Bowser has kids, and then the next day saying they're adopted. I mean, come on, Miyamoto. What are you doing? Oh my god, please don't die. Please. Oh my god, please don't die. I'm concentrating! I'm doing sign language. Oh my. OMG. Well, it's supposed to be. Birdo is the mother of the Koppelings. I don't know. I think. Isn't Birdo transgender? See? And then Nintendo's doing that too. It's like, oh, Birdo is actually transgender. Like, okay. Or, I don't know. They said something like that at one time. And I'm like, well, whatever you say, Nintendo. I don't mind it. It just. It's gonna be kind of hard to, you know, explain to the kids that, but, you know, maybe it's time that they learn that there's transgender. I don't know. That's like the Overwatch characters, you know? My favorite character is Symmetra, and then Blizzard said Symmetra is autistic. Okay, I guess. Still like her. But of course, like, the fans, the community gets all, like, pissy about it. Like, how can you make Symmetra autistic? Like, it's, like, a big deal. It's not a big deal. She's a character. And then the main character that's on all the box art and everything. Forgetting her name for some reason. I barely play as her. She's supposed to be gay, and it's like, oh, that's a big deal for people. Just a character. I mean, is it a big deal because people can't, like, you know, have fantasies about her or something? I can't have fantasies about her if she likes girls. She has to like me, says the 50-year-old Tracer. 50-year-old Tracer lover. He's like, she can't be gay. Think about her all the time. When I mean think about her, I mean think about her. As we move on to Dr. Wily's castle, oh my gosh, there's still like 1, 2, 3 levels left. Possibly 4, if there's like another skull after that skull. That usually happens in Mega Man. So guys, thank you for being up with me tonight on this Saturday morning. Is it Saturday morning for me? I don't even know what time it is. That's why I'm confused. No, it's still Friday. Friday night for me. It might be Saturday morning for you guys. It is 11:30 here in California, and I'm spending my night with you playing Mega Man Cinco, Mega Man 5 for the PS Quadruple. You know, when there's cool people out there going out, drinking, partying, I'm here playing Nintendo games from the 1990s on my PlayStation 4. Ton of men fell in love with Tracer's ass. Well, you know, why not? If you're gonna fall in love with an ass, why can't it be a video game character? people are strange. That you could be attracted to a video game character. It's like a cartoon. It's like a cartoon. It's like being attracted to Jessica Rabbit, you know? I think I gamed over more in this than the other games. This is kind of sad, actually. So what are you saying, James? So they got mad because nobody has a change at least you a gamer girl. What? I don't get what you said, James. I think the English is kind of off there. It's because men fell in love with Tracer's ass, so they got mad because nobody has a chance, at least you a gamer girl. I am sucking at this game, guys. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm gonna be like a baby and use not rush coil, the dog jet. Dog jet across. Yeah, dog jet. For my pathetic gameplay right now. Okay, now let's get that. So we need that. We need as many E-tanks as humanly possible. Yeah, but, you know, guys falling in love with video game characters, I guess that's been around for a while, you know. Back in the day, it was Sonya Blade, it was, the Tomb Raider, Lara Croft, you know. Goes on and on. Let's see. Oh, are you? Oh, please don't die! Okay. Almost had a heart attack. From Mega Man. Oh, are you watching this on your phone, James? Or are you watching it on... Like, what are you watching it on? I'm assuming you're watching it on your phone. Let's see. Don't die. Okay. Don't die, don't die, don't die, don't die. I am on the edge of glory right now. Please don't die. Jump! Okay. Well, at least I got across. That's all I wanted to do. That's cool. Yeah, like I said, I usually watch people stream on my PS4, so, it's kind of interesting to always figure out where people watch me from, whether it's from their computer, their phone, their TV, I keep saying you know over and over. Why does it... Rote sucking? I don't know what you're saying, man. Okay. I just would like to get to the end of the level and beat it because... I think I've spent more time on this Mega Man. Well, dying does add to it, but I suppose this Mega Man might be a little longer than the others, but I did die plenty of times in this, so that adds to it. I was hoping that I can get through the game in like an hour 45 or something, but obviously not gonna happen. It's like 1:59 at this point. Mice are annoying. Oh, the chicken again. Oh, little chicken! I think I was talking about the Robot Masters and the robots and Mega Man, how it's like, what's the purpose of these, like, chicken ones, and what do they serve in the Mega Man universe? I don't know. Oh, I made it. this guy again. Okay, hopefully he jumps far. Yes. Oh, well, jump again. What is this? Okay, jump. Of course! Jump right on top of me. Please be an easy boss, please be an easy boss, please be an easy boss. I don't remember this boss. The boss, and I died again. This is pathetic. This is absolutely pathetic, my friends, my viewers, friends, subscribers, and or subscribers. Oh man. Oh my God. I am just. Well, I do have E-Tanks. I'm just gonna use my E-Tanks, guys. I don't wanna keep playing these bosses over and over again. It's getting annoying. I was trying to save the E-Tanks for the end, but looks like it's not gonna happen. Well, I've got four of them, though. What's happening here? God, I can't even see. Yeah, boss music is really boring. The music in this whole game is not as good as the previous entries, so I don't understand. I mean, it's an okay game. It's not as good as the others, but it's okay. I think the top three Mega Man games are 2, 3, and 9. Then everyone has opinions about the other ones. What's happening to my life? That I'm dying in Mega Man. I'm dying in Mega Man 5. What's happening to me? I've fallen so poorly in my gaming life that I'm dying in Mega Man 5 of all the games. Oh, it's pathetic, guys. Pathetic. I did not die as much in other games, and I'm just dying over and over in this one. Sorry that you have to watch all this again. I'm sorry I have to play it again. I really don't like playing unless it's like a speed run, I guess, but I don't like doing things over and over. But video games teach you a valuable lesson in life, guys and gals. That first you don't succeed, you try again until you do. So these NES games where you have to keep, you know, you fail and you fail and you fail, and you just keep going, and, so that is a true lesson that video games teach us. Oh my gosh, I'm at the edge. That's not gonna be safe. That could end in my demise. Even if it takes 20 years. Yeah, that's true. There's really no such thing as failure, guys, unless you quit. That's what I've kind of learned in life. Or you die, you know, in reality. I mean, dying is not a failure, I'm just saying. When you die, like, that's it. You can't try anymore, so. You know. What you gonna do? You got a lot of time sleeping, what is that? I don't know what sleep is. I don't know. It's this thing where you like lay down and close your eyes and like you wake up again. I've always said I wish there was no such thing as sleep, but I guess life would be different. Jobs would probably be like 14 hours a day, 16 hours a day. Oh no, I'm not gonna give up. I don't quit. I I was just like talking about like in general, video games teach us about life in a way where you shouldn't quit things, you know. If you fail, you just keep going. Keep going. Just try different things and you'll find your way. So what else is going on in the gaming world, guys? That's what we want to figure out. E3 is coming up. That's always a big deal. My sister mentioned Nintendo's not going to have a conference. I don't think they... Oh, God! Why?
Why do I have to die?
Nintendo's not going to have a conference. And they haven't had a conference for a couple years. But she's saying they're not going to be at E3 at all, which I don't believe. But I'm going to have to look into that. Because she said, no, I saw on Twitter. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm going to have to check it out because... I'm sure they're going to be at E3, they're just not going to have like a big press conference, but I'd be very surprised if they're not even there. So I'll check that out, but E3 is coming up, hopefully we'll get some new games on the horizon. Speaking of Horizon, I still need to beat Horizon Zero Dawn, which I also put away. So I was like, you know what? I never played, or I never beat Final Fantasy XV, so I better go beat that first. And then I'll beat Horizon and Zelda. Because if I don't do it, I'll never do it. I'll just forget about it, you know? I'll just buy a new game, I'll get whatever. I'll go back to Resident Evil 7 again, because I want to do the hard mode and that, and, you know. Sometimes we just forget about games that we were playing. Thank God I didn't die again. Now let's try to get past this guy without dying. Or getting hit. Let's see. Good. Oh yeah, Injustice 2 is coming out. That's a good, that'll be a good game. I like the first one. I should just get the first one, but I got Mortal Kombat and they're very similar, so I don't want to get two of the same kind of game. Oh my god. This is getting like annoying at this point. This is getting annoying at this point. So I might have to do that little bit concentration mode here. I don't know if these balls coming from the sky, what's going on with that? Oh, I might have to use another E-Tank for this. This is pathetic on my part. Pathetic. I'm just getting hit over and over again. Dang it. I'm gonna do it because I really don't want to keep starting over, over and over and over. See, that's what I'm doing. That's my new plan is use old E-Tanks, guys. All of them. Injustice 2, yes. What else is coming out that you guys are looking forward to playing? Let's see. What am I interested in playing? On the Switch, I look forward to Splatoon 2, Mario Odyssey. On the PS4, it's coming out on PS4. They're gonna remake Final Fantasy 12, or they did, so I'll probably pick that up down the road. I think I mentioned that already. But that's, like, something that's not a remake, though, what's coming out. Destiny 2 is coming out. I played the first one, but I never bought it, so I don't know if I'll get Destiny 2. Star Wars Battlefront 2, which, you know, a lot of people gave the first Battlefront a hard time, but I actually really like this. I think it's just fun. I know it's a casual game. It's pretty casual for a multiplayer shooter. But it's Star Wars, people! I like the glitches. I like the bad spawns. It doesn't matter. It's fun. It's fun because it's stupid fun. Crash Bandicoot, yes! I want to get that. The trilogy. Remastered trilogy is coming out. I guess I don't know who's in what capsule here, so... yes! Crash Bandicoot trilogy. I don't know. It's called, like, Insane Trilogy or something like that, right? Yeah, I look forward to that. I played the first Crash Bandicoot on PS1, but that was it. I didn't play the other one, so that's cool that they're coming out with all of them. I think I have one more. I beat him last time with the Buster only, anyways. Yeah, it's fine. Who's next? Oh, this was the slide, right? I don't want to use E-Tanks, but I don't want to keep going I don't want to do this over and over again. I'm kind of getting frustrated with this game. I'm doing so bad on it. You know, like when you do bad on a game and you just start getting mad at it? That's when you should stop playing it. That happens when I play Overwatch. Like, once I start feeling like I'm getting mad, I'm like, okay, I have to stop playing it. You know, whether it's your teammates are being dumb, or... your teammates are just being stupid, or terrible, and you're just losing a lot in competitive, and it's time to just get off and play something else, or stop playing altogether. I'm starting to feel not frustrated that the game is, like, I'm losing in this. It's just, like, it's embarrassing. This game is not hard, people. And I've just been dying time after time in this game tonight. So, I don't know if it's because I'm talking to you at the same time, and I don't know what the excuse is. I'm just not doing a good job tonight with this game. But please, watch my other streams and see how awesome I am at Mega Man. who kills the choo-choo train? I don't remember.
You choo-choo choose me?
Anybody know where that's from? This is not the weapon. I don't remember the weapons in this game. I never remember them. Is it that one? Oh my god. Oh, this is really embarrassing. I don't even care anymore. I don't even care, you guys. I'm just gonna try to beat the game. One Piece. What is James saying? Isn't the beauty of retro games when you get so mad and scream, and then 5 seconds after you calm down, you are better and pick up the Simpsons? Yeah, the thing is, like, you get frustrated, but you can't let the frustration defeat you. You know, if I rage quitted this game right now, that would be pathetic on my part. This game is not hard, and if I start getting really mad, like, I hate Mega Man 5, that's pathetic. You get mad, and then you just keep going, but, like, games like Overwatch, though, you know, sometimes you can get really frustrated because you lose because of your teammates. So it's like you have no control over it. So that just gets annoying, and then you're like, alright, I don't want to play this right now. I don't want to play this right now. And because it's just a multiplayer game, you can just leave it and just come back another time. And then the other night, I was on a team where I won like 7 games in a row on competitive, and I was like, finally! I found a good team. I wish I had them as friends. Dang it, I was mad at myself I didn't, like, add them on PSN. They were pretty good. We were all, like, a good, solid team together. Who kills this guy? That blinking one, but who had that? Gravity one, right? Yeah. And I'm losing my voice right now, talking so much. Yeah! But we're moving forward. Who kills the crystal boy here? Was it the water? I don't even remember, you guys. I don't remember. Does his own weapon kill him? Let's see. Oh my gosh, Ball City. No. Was it this? I don't remember. How come I don't remember? Oh, it is this. Yeah, it'd be nice if I don't get hit. That'd be nice.
Oh my god, I'm really doing bad today. I am doing terrible in Mega Man today, guys. I am so sorry. I apologize from the bottom of my heart how bad I'm doing in Mega Man today. Can you throw your stars, please? Thanks. I don't know why I'm being quiet on this guy. This guy's not even hard, and I'm getting my ass kicked by him too, so... Come on, man! Come on! You choose me! Belmont, thanks for the love, man. I'm just... It's embarrassing. But it's okay, now it's an official game capsule of TV Live, but, and it's gonna be in the playlist, so... My pathetic... Gameplay will forever be on YouTube of Mega Man 5. You know, that is if YouTube is still around forever. I mean, I'm hearing all these things that, you know, they're gonna cut back on ad revenue and all this stuff, so I don't know, guys! YouTube looks like it's in trouble! And all the, like, the big YouTubers like, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do? You know? It was this one, right? So we'll see. If you're a small YouTuber and you want to do something with YouTube, what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus on the audience. I don't even care about the money. I want to build an audience on YouTube, even if it's a decent amount. If I surpass AG Entertainment, I'll be happy. That's how I feel at this point. And AG Entertainment has 15,000, so I'm already halfway there, I guess. Sort of. No, I'm not halfway there. I'm thinking 1,500.
Oh my god!
Rage! Oh, James, these Mega Man walkthroughs, they were from, like, 2008. The ones I did on AG Entertainment, they're from, like, when I was in college. What is this boss? How do you avoid it? Alright. Doesn't it break, like, the bottom? Like, the floor breaks into more spikes? I'm pretty sure it does. I'm just gonna use my peripherals and look on the ground to kind of see where Wily's gonna go. Maybe I can avoid him easier. Let's see. Yeah, kind of helps, but kind of makes me dizzy. I don't know if you guys have tricks like that when you play video games, like using your peripheral vision. I'm not watching Wily, I'm just kind of watching the floor and, watching Wily through my peripheral vision, so then I can dodge him easier. Because watching him was making me, like, couldn't really figure out where he was gonna go. Okay, good. Whew! I'm sick of dying in this dumb game. It's not dumb, I'm just... getting mad at it for no reason. This stupid game, I'm sick of it. Yeah, James, when I did those Mega Man walkthroughs on AG Entertainment, that was like 2008, 2009. That was a long time ago. It's like almost 10 years ago already. I think this Wily boss... Is this a hard one? I don't remember how hard this Wily boss is. Oh, it's being dramatic.
Is this another one that he's in the dark and then he disappears? Yeah. Oh, wait, no. I don't remember this. I think that gyrocopter thing kills it. Let's see. No. What is it? It's not that, huh? Crystal? No. The bomb, probably. Okay, I guess nothing, huh? Dr. Wily? Mega Buster, buddy? Alright, we're just gonna fill everything up. Gonna fill it up to the max. Because I really don't wanna die again. You guys understand that? Once again, thank you guys for being here tonight. I appreciate it. I mean, I really do. It's my privilege to give you terrible Mega Man 5 gameplay. so sorry for the bad gameplay. You can tell I haven't played this game as much as the other ones. Yeah, okay, and then it goes in the dark and... Original Capcom. Original! I'm okay. See, and I use all my E-tanks on the stupid Robot Masters. On what do you play this? On what do you play this? It's called Mega Man Legacy Collection. It has Mega Man 1 through 6 on it. It's pretty cool. Even though the GameCube version was a better collection. I mean, come on, Capcom, you're being bastards here. They might do a second Mega Man Legacy, who knows? I swear. I don't know what's happening tonight. I really don't know what's happening. I am truly embarrassed, but what can I do? We're at the end. We're at the end. I can't stop now. Can't quit now. Almost there. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm dying from stupid robots outside the boss. Don't have any E-tanks left, so now I just gotta be pro. So excuse me if I'm a little quiet during this part. Gotta be pro. Oh, that's not pro. That's... Oh, man. Okay, here we go. Come on, Mega Man. Let's not jump into the balls, thank you. Oh my gosh, come on. Oh my god, dying from stupid robots! Oh, and they respawn, of course.
his NES here. Oh my god, respawned again. Oh, you guys, I am getting so mad right now. I'm getting so mad. Oh my god. Alright, here we go. Concentrate like you do. Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Because it's that Wily has those two forms, you know? And the second form is annoying because it's like you can't see him at all times. Oh, don't get hit. Okay. I have a full bar of health. That might help a tad. Okay, here we go. Here we go, here we go. Here we go. Ugh, shooting with rockets. I always forgot about those. Why are you jumping? Ugh, I'm talking to myself. More rockets, okay. Sucking me. Sucking me close. Damn it. Rockets, okay. Alright. Now don't be dumb. And don't get hit by freaking Wily. Okay, wait. I gotta find out which weapon kills him. I think it's this. Pretty sure it's this. Don't get hit by him on the floor. Did that do anything? I don't know. I didn't see. Don't get hit by him. I don't know. I'm just gonna keep using it. Screw it! Okay, don't get hit by him. Okay, good. That doesn't do anything. Maybe it's the rock thing, but I don't want to test it. I'm just gonna... Yeah, this has no range, though. Can't shoot upwards. There's no weapon like the metal blades in this game. Looks like it's doing something. I'm just gonna keep going. Just gonna keep going. Okay. Okay. Almost. Okay. Don't hit me on the floor. Oh, good. All right. Okay. Ball's going in circles. Okay. Don't get hit on the ground. All right. Just dodge. Good. Okay, good. I'm just gonna take it slow. I'm gonna take it nice and slow. Oh, son of a bitch! This is not the weapon. Just go Mega Buster script. I'll probably do more damage on them. Why did I slide? Oh my gosh. Okay, I cannot get hit now. Be quiet. So nerve-wracking. Oh! You son of a bitch! You bastard! Oh my god! Damn it! Oh my gosh, I was like sweating from that. And then he peers right on top of my head and just takes a dump on it. Oh god, that kills me, guys. Kills me.
Oh, Belmont, I'm telling you, man. That's killer. That's killer. James, it's upsetting, man. I'm telling you. So close, yet so far. And I don't know why I did that slide. Did you guys see that? I did not... I must have accidentally. I don't know how or why I slid. That ruined it. I could have made it if I didn't slide. Alright, here we go. I'm going to do concentrate again. I know I have a lot of energy this time, but it's going to be the same thing where I'm just going to stay focused. Stay focused and... focused, I guess. I can't think of another word at this present time. Oh, almost took a dump on my head again. Almost took a dump on my head. Okay. No, not today, Wily. Not today. Or, I guess not this time, because you've dumped on my head plenty of times, I guess, tonight. I'm telling you guys, this is the worst I've ever played this game. As you watch my other Mega Man streams, I'm not bad at Mega Man, but for some reason, tonight, it's an off night. Here we are, Dr. Wily versus Rockman, Mega Man, whatever you want to call him. One-on-one. Who will survive? Mega Man. Or the crazy, wild-eyed scientist, Dr. Wily. Oh, almost crapped in my head again. Nope. It's just I can't reach, so... See, if I had that bird power up, this is where you would use it. Because that bird, if you spell out Mega Man 5 there, you get the bird power up, and the bird can go attack Wily when he's up high. So it's very useful to have. At this part... I only missed a couple letters. I should have got it. Damn it. What was I doing? It's because you're watching me. No, that's crazy talk. Because I'm just playing like crap today! On episode 5 of the Game Capsule Live. Playing like crap on official playlist series. Why not, I guess? It'll be in the record books. AG struggled with Mega Man 5. It's on video. We got him on video. Losing to the dumbest bosses. Losing to Wily plenty of times. Oh my gosh, concentrate. Oh my gosh. Okay. Wily's just... He's abusing me. He's abusing me, guys. I can't do it anyway. Let's keep going. Let's go. Don't have any E-tanks. I need E-tanks, guys. I use all my E-tanks. I can't breathe. I can't breathe, guys. Okay. I gotta concentrate. Dr. Wily is killing me. Don't get hit by this crap. Don't get hit by the balls in your face. Don't let the balls hit you in the face. You idiot, Mega Man. You don't like the balls in your face. Those big balls, the big blue balls in your face. Okay. Alright, concentration is key, you son of a bitch, Wily. And a half in this bitch-ass game. And I was telling my sister, oh, it's only gonna take an hour and a half to beat this game. Don't worry, I'm not gonna be playing it all night. Mega Man 5. Pathetic. Pathetic. Come on, please, Dr. Wily, can you just come down to my level so I can shoot you in the freaking face. Can't shoot you when you're up there, okay? Can't shoot you when you're up in the sky. Can't reach you, see that? Can't reach you when you're in the sky. Can't reach you when you're right there. Oh, you son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Okay, you know what? I need to test this. Nope, ricocheting right off his freaking glass! Alright, that's not gonna do it. Does this do anything? Oh, okay. Kinda see where he's gonna end up. Is it doing anything? Oh, no. Stars? I don't know about the stars. I just need something that's gonna hurt him more than what I'm doing. I don't think the stars are going to do anything, but we'll, I don't know. I don't remember what kills him. It might just be the Mega Buster. Please come down to my level. No, that did nothing. I'm just gonna stick with what I was doing. That seemed like it was doing damage, but I don't like this whole waiting, the whole waiting for him to come down to my level thing. You know what I mean? Ugh. All right, we're tied now in energy, so. Sorry, I'm not looking at the chat right now. I really don't want to be. I don't want to do this again. So. So I'm super concentrating.
I'm concentrating super much.
Super much. A plus in English for me. I got the trophy for beating Mega Man 5. It only took 2 hours and 39 minutes. I don't even care what the ending is. Whoa! What's going on? Oh, Mega Man is like Superman now. That's not realistic, because Mega Man would have been crushed if I was playing it. It would have been like... Just like in the other level. Remember the other level when the stage was falling? Oh, Dr. Wily got away! Is there gonna be a Mega Man 6? probably. And there you have it, folks. My terrible gameplay of Mega Man 5. It's really not that hard. I don't know why I struggled so much with it tonight. I used plenty of E-tanks. I died at bosses I shouldn't have died at. I spent way too much time on Dr. Wily. But there you have it. Mega Man 5 with all the dumb robot masters, except Gravity Man. I think Gravity Man's kind of cool, but... yeah, this guy's kind of cool, too. Looks like Shovel Knight stole that guy and put them in their game, except the Shovel Knight one was green and he has the copter thing on top. Starman, that's pretty dumb. Choo Choo Train Man, that's pretty dumb too. I'm sorry, Mr. Toshiaki Shiguriara. Apologize. Napalm, kinda cool, I guess. I mean, Napalm is pretty dangerous, so okay. I mean, the name sounds funny, but... Crystal Man?
I don't know about Crystal Man.
Told you, AG, you struggled because I was watching. I'm bad luck. Why are you bad luck, Belmont? Why? There you have it, folks. Mega Man 5. Next time, playing Mega Man 6. Hopefully, I won't be struggling as much as I did here, because I should not be spending 3 hours playing a Mega Man game. I know this game is a little longer than the other ones, but Mega Man 5 is not that bad, and I struggled with it tonight. I died, and died again, and used E-Tank after E-Tank, and, here you go, you have it on record, so... anybody want to use this against me in the future, go ahead. AG is bad at video games. He struggled with Mega Man 5. off night, people. Off night. I played 1 through 4 so far. You can go check those out. I didn't struggle as much as I did here, but... it's Mega Man. I beat it in one sitting, so... you know, back in the day, we didn't do that. That's why you gotta write those passwords down after every stage, you know what I mean? So these are all the Japanese guys that made the game. Patariko and Bamboo and Royu and Mari composed the music. Or the sound, excuse me. And it's presented by... oh, see, that's the bird you get if I actually spelled out Mega Man 5. Presented by Capcom. Guys, gals... thanks for watching and thanks for everybody being here tonight. It's late. Well, not really late for me, because I'll probably be up playing more Final Fantasy 15 for a little bit. My phone died, I guess. I don't know. I'm trying to check it. But, yeah. Next video, we're playing Mega Man 6. So, what's say, Friday? Might do that Sunday night? Maybe? Possibly? Not sure. So we'll see. I'll let you know. I'll hop notifications out. Be subscribed to the channel. Yeah, you know, if you're around, you'll be here. But like I said, a schedule will be coming in the future for videos and streams and everything. So look forward to that, because then you'll know when I'll be streaming on YouTube and on Twitch and making videos for the channel and everything. I am turning the game capsule into a online video game store. I don't know if you guys knew that, but that's what I've been working on most of the time, so that's why I haven't been around as much. So when everything falls into place, you'll be seeing me around much more. Game capsule is going to be pushed a lot more in the coming months, and, you know, it's going to be a good time, fun time. So, I look forward to it. I hope you do too. It's fun. It's all fun stuff. So, here we are. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I am AG, your humble host of the Game Capsule live on YouTube and on Twitch. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for being here, everyone. I appreciate it.